Fruit. Fruit of the Spirit.
Fruit of the Spirit. Now the question is, I want to ask the first question. When you hear something like fruit of the Spirit, what first comes into your mind? Yeah. When you hear fruit of the Spirit, what first comes into your mind? Because to me, I felt like fruit comes from tree. And then spirit. So tree is not spirit, right? And then they said fruit of the Spirit. So what does it mean? So what comes to your mind? Me, I'm confused. So I want somebody to teach me tonight. So what comes to your mind? Fruit of the Spirit. I'm going to call him. I think I like Damola. I like every one of you, but I want to start with Damola. Damola, what comes to your mind when you hear fruit of the Spirit? Damola, we are waiting for you.
I think like the heart of the Spirit, so like really deep into the Spirit, like someone's spirit would be like the hope, for example, would be their spirit. I'm not really sure.
Okay, you're not really sure, but you tried. I really like that. I like people making an attempt. So, Damola made an attempt, and she finally says she's not really sure. Can somebody really help her out? You don't need to know the right answer. I just want to know, because I'm confused. What does it mean by fruit of the Spirit? Fire coming.
I think it means, like, qualities that we aim to have, like love and, like respect, forgiveness, honesty, and like all of that stuff.
Okay. So how far do you think that qualities we need to have, like love, all that stuff? I love that, all that stuff. So those all that stuff, can somebody help her out? What are the all that stuff? I'm going to call Deborah.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm with you. We are with you.
What was the question again?
Yeah, the question is, when we hear the fruit of the Spirit, what does it mean by the fruit of the Spirit? What first comes to our mind?
It means that it should be it should be generous.
Okay. Is that all?
No. You should always help people.
Okay. Is that all?
Yeah.
Okay. So Deborah said, okay, we should be generous, we should always help people. Every one of you gave a very good part. I mean, so good. But you know, what I'm expecting is, I'm just a layman. I mean, but possibly I didn't go to school. I didn't even go to secondary school, you understand? And it's so amazing to me, because when I was small, my mom would say fruit. Anytime they talk about fruit, I'll think about apple, I'll think about pineapple, I'll think about a whole lot of, you know, what you can eat in a crab and leaf. I'll think about a lot of other stuff. But when you're now saying that fruit of the Spirit, it means that so the Spirit produces fruit also. So what does it mean? So if we say that the fruit of the Spirit, so it means that the Spirit produces fruit. So, and the qualities of a tree is to produce fruit. So if the Bible says the fruit of the Spirit, so it simply means that the Spirit have a kind of fruit it's producing. So the Bible is trying to tell us that the Spirit is like a tree that's producing fruit. Do you see that? So how? Now, in my own thinking, I begin to think, how can the Spirit produce fruit? So, but before we now go into that fully, can we all be together in one Bible verse? We want to meet somewhere in the Bible now.
That's shalom.
Thank you. doesn't know. He just likes stealing pencil. And I'm like, how can somebody like stealing? How can it be? And the reason why it can be so is because the everything will do are always controlled by what controls our spirit. Now listen, I told you that your spirit is in the spiritual world, right? Now listen, something must be controlling that your spirit. Is either the force of God or evil force. If it is the devil, then the devil will be telling your spirit, oh yeah, go and steal, oh yeah, go and commit fornication, oh yeah, go and kill, oh yeah, lie, oh yeah, do this. But if it's God controlling your spirit, then you'll be hearing things like your spirit will be so much happy in doing the things of God, being gentle, being peaceful, being kind, and all the rest that was being mentioned in the Bible. So now you see how your spirit can influence your actions. Hello? Are you with me?
Yes.
Now listen, I also want to tell you something because I'm going to ask you a lot of questions. Because I've said a whole lot of things. Now in the Bible, we have read what the fruit of the Spirit is. We said it is love. Now what is love? The last time you met me, we talked about the neighbor, right? I told you who your neighbor is. And I said that it's somebody that you help, right? And you cannot help somebody who don't love them, right? So that means if you love people, you are exercising the fruit of the Spirit, and that is love. Love simply means you like somebody. It doesn't matter if the person is your neighbor, I mean somebody living opposite your flat. It doesn't matter if the person is not your neighbor or anything. So far is a human being. God said you should love him. You see that? Now, the second point is joy. What is joy? Joy is a state of satisfaction when you are always smiling, when things doesn't disturb you, when they look at you and say, oh, I love that woman's face today. She's looking joyous. That can always be by the spirit. Now, the third point is peace. What do you mean by peace? What are we trying to say when we talk about peace? Peace simply means, you know, is it possible for somebody to slap you and you'll be smiling? Is it possible? Hello?
No.
Is it possible for me to slap you now and you are smiling?
No.
No. Okay, I want to ask you another question. Is it possible for you to have an exam tomorrow and you are busy playing?
No.
Why? Because you are anxious. You want to read, right? Then your spirit will be disturbed, right? But the Bible says that when you have the fruit of the Spirit in you, you will not fear. There will be the spirit of peace in your mind. And you will say, oh, either you are going to write an exam tomorrow, say, Mommy, God got this. I have read. I have prepared so well, so I don't need to fear anymore. God will help. That's the peace of God. Our point is kindness. What does it mean to be kind? I want to ask someone. If I say, Bodu Olami is kind, what do I mean? Bodu, I'm asking. If I tell you that you are kind, what does it mean to be kind? Bodu?
That you are a good person.
Good person, okay. What else? Who else can also say something about being kind? Kizaya. We are waiting for you, Kezia.
Oh, yeah, it's really loud. It's really loud.
You what?
It's really loud, so I don't know if it's still.
I didn't get you. You said it's really loud.
It's really loud.
So, what's the question?
You can hear me sing, right?
Yeah, I can hear you, but like around my young screen. Really loud.
Okay, no problem. Who else can I call? Shara.
helping and you try not to hurt like people's feelings.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you need to have that completed in all of that. It simply means to be loving. It simply means to be, you know, you are always there to help people. You are always there. When people come to you, you are always wanting to help. I mean, you are not this kind of a person that when they say, oh, say something, I don't know if it's something, you just say one sharp word. People that are kind are always nice. And that's what it seems.
couldn't hear anything because my internet kept getting oozing.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah, a bit.
Okay, I said she mentioned four out of the seven fruits of the Spirit we mentioned in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22.
I didn't hear, I'm not sure I would hear what you were saying yet.
Okay.
Also, you've not been with me since, right?
Yeah, yeah, make sure you watch the video, please, okay? Ian, make sure you watch the video after the class.
Fire coming will help out. So fire coming, can you please tell us four, and please, Ian, listen. Can you please tell us four out of the seven fruits of the Spirit in Galatians chapter 5 verse
2? Love.
One.
Joy.
Two.
Gentleness.
Three.
Self-control.
Self-control. I love that. Can somebody help us with the remaining three? Somebody help us, Ola, we're waiting for you.
Peacefulness.
One. Three. I need you to mention three that has not been mentioned before. We are waiting for you, Ola.
You forgot the rest.
Are you with your Bible? You're not with your Bible here. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to tell you the right to reply to. I would like you to say it after me. So please unmute. Okay, so we have not mentioned patience. I'd like you to say it after me. Patience.
Kindness.
And goodness. We have not mentioned faithfulness too. Okay. So now, yeah, unmute your mic. Yeah. Now, can you hear me very well?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you hurt my feelings when you said you are not with me since the time I've been talking, and I felt a bit bad. Now see, I would like you to give us the three, just four, of the fruit of the Spirit.
Okay. Peacefulness.
One, yeah.
Self-control.
Two.
Kindness.
Three.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness. Thank you. Now you're, I'm now happy now, yeah. Okay, you're now. Praise God. So now, we are able to understand these are the fruit of the Spirit. Now, can somebody please explain to me what does it mean have self-control? Now I'm going to call him, you know, I'm a bit pushy, right? Yeah, I'm going to call him. Deborah, what does it mean to have self-control? Deborah, what does it mean to have self-control?
It means that you should always control yourself even in the bad situations that you are put in.
Okay, I love that. We should always control ourselves, even in a bad situation that we have. Okay, can somebody explain to me what does it mean to be gentle? What does it mean to be gentle? Boru? I think Boru has gone. Shalom.
With hunger.
What does it mean to be gentle?
Like how you're a cow and so grown to make a rocket of a little bit.
Okay, can you please get closer to your mic?
I am closer.
Okay, now can you please speak up a bit?
So what I mean by kindness is like how you're doing things, how kind you're doing things. If you're gentle, have a gentle mind, so don't make things bad for yourself.
Okay. It simply means when you are kind and doing things, you know, that's what gentleness means. You really means kind, tender. You know, when they say somebody is mild, you know, it's not so lousy, it's not dangerous. Somebody is so, you know, cool, a cool type of a person. Now, and that's how we should behave, even in the public. That's how we should behave even in class, even in
sorry in advance. One of them, the body.
Okay.
Spirit.
Two.
The soul.
Okay. So, you may mention of spirit. I think you love that, but you said it came then. Wow. So, when did you join the class?
Maybe 20 minutes past started.
Oh, really? I didn't feel that. Okay, but you really got it right. So, we are attributed to, as we've been formed by the body, the spirit, and the soul. And that's what Miriam actually said, and I really love that. She joined us late and she got it. I really love that. So now, you now know, by now, that you are not just an Ola. There is Ola of the body, there is Ola of the soul, and there is Ola of the spirit. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? And this spirit is what we are talking about that needs to produce these fruits. And these are the fruits that we need to produce. So can somebody explain? I would like Blessing to explain what does it mean
to be caring and helpful, to be charitable, to help people when they're in need, even if they're not your neighbor, or they could be a stranger, or anything, just to help everyone despite anything.
Now you're very right. That's a perfect example of a perfect explanation of being kind. So if I want to ask a question, how will you be able to know that this person is walking in the spirit? Okay, let me put it this way. How will you be able to know that the spirit of this person is producing good fruits? If you meet, for example, you meet somebody in your school or your friend or something. So how will you be able to know that person, the spirit of that person, is producing good fruits? How? How they are acting. So now, can you tell me what are their attributes that you will see and you will say, this person is producing good fruits?
Well, in school, or in general.
They must be?
Is it in school or in general?
In general.
Maybe if they read the Bible, the Christian, the church, maybe if they work with a person, a citizen person, doesn't do any bad action, doesn't behave in a bad way.
Okay. Exactly. You're right. Maybe they don't go, they are very bad, they don't walk in the path of the sinners and some other things. But can you tell me what are the names of the fruits that their spirits are producing that makes you think that they are good?
Maybe it's self-control, or maybe what?
One? No, it's not maybe. It's one of them. We just read it.
Okay. Self-control, kindness.
Kindness, two.
Faithfulness.
Three.
Love.
Two. Four.
There's many of them.
There's so many of them. We just read it. So now, what the Bible is just trying to tell me is that if you want to know, this kind of a person, I want to work with a person. This person wants to be my friend, or I want to be the friend of this person. And the Bible says that you should be afraid of good people. Now, the question is, how will you be able to know good people? Now, the first thing you look at is the fruit of the Spirit. You will ask yourself, is this person gentle? Is this person kind? Does this person have self-control? This person, is he a loving person? Is he always joyous? Does he have peace? Is he patient enough to listen to corrections? Does he accept correction? Is he gentle? And these are the things. If you are able to mark all these things, and say, is he gentle? Say, yes, he's gentle. You notice it? Does he have self-control or does she have self-control? Say, yes, she has. Then you mark it. And you are able to see all these fruit of the Spirit in the person. Then, I can assure you, this person is a good person. Now, how can I know that this person is a bad person?
They're doing bad. If you see them doing bad.
Shut up, you're talking too much. Thank you. I want somebody else to talk.
Shalom. Shalom.
From their personality and from their actions.
From the personality and the actions, yeah. But you can also say if they are not producing the fruit of the Spirit, if you look at them and you discover that they are not gentle, they don't have self-control, they are not faithful, they lie too much, they are not good, they are bad people, they smoke, they are drunkards, they say every sort of nonsense. They are not joyful. They don't love people, they hate people. You know, some people say, I hate you. Those kind of people run away from them. They are not exercising the fruit of the Spirit. Even if you see them in church, run away. They are not good. And you see that they are not peaceful. They are not kind. They are not patient. They always do, you know, they always jump up and down. They are too lousy. I mean, they always want everybody to see them. Those kind of people, then you know that these people are not good at all. And at this point, I'm going to draw the curtain because my time is already up, and I'm going to hand over to Sister Joy. But Ben, I want to ask a question. Did you learn something into this class?
Yes, sir. I learned more about the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I learned more about the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
The fruit of the Holy Spirit. I want to hear a very harmonious yes or no. Do you learn something in this class?
Yes.
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 So I'm a wonderful thing.
Yeah, thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's clap for Brother Sheyi, everybody. Let's clap for him. He's an amazing teacher, honestly. He's so amazing, he's so amazing, he's so amazing. God bless you, sir. Thanks for breaking down, you know, that session for us. And I believe everyone enjoyed it, so I'm so happy. So Shalom is just the super, super mom of the class tonight. It was just, you know, contributing. So guys, I want you to be talking in class. I want everybody to be talking. So thank you so much for your contribution, everyone. So tonight we've learned a lot. I'm just going to call two people to summarize my class, and I think they know themselves what I'm going to call tonight. I'm just going to call someone who has not been talking since. So let me start with, okay, I'll take our call Blessing. So Blessing, do you want to summarize what we've learned tonight? So quick. And of course, I'll call Kesaya. Fantastic. We got some more time. Thank you. Let's clap for Blessing, everyone. Let's clap for Blessing. Well done. You're doing well. So the next one I'm just going to call now is Kesaya, and it's Damola there, because Damola network keep jumping in. Is Damola there now? Okay, I think she's not here. Okay, Kesaya, do you want to tell us what you've learned tonight? If mommy has you, you've joined, what are you going to tell mom? Or meet yourself, darling. Yeah. Thank you, darling. God bless you. Let's start for Kesaya. Well done. Let me just call Olawale, and then we'll go into our prayers, and that will be the end of the session. So Olawale, darling, do you want to meet yourself and talk? What have you learned tonight? Oh, I think I'll call Olawale there. I'll call Bolu. Yeah, call Bolu. I've had Shalom voice. I've had Favor. I didn't hear Favor, so I'm going to call Favor. Okay, let's be quick. Olawale, meet yourself, darling, and tell me what you've learned tonight.
Mm-hmm. I learned that you should always be kind to God. You should not disrespect His name about anything, and we should always respect His name and never disrespect His name in any kind of situation, even at the point where they feel like you don't believe in God.
Okay, thank you, darling. Let's clap for Lawa. That's a good attempt. Let's clap for him. Well done. So kindness, that's what Lawale is taking away today out of the fruit of the spirit. That's fantastic. So let me just call on Favor, unmute yourself, darling. And Bolu, I don't want to spend 1 minute late, so let's be quick. So where's Favor? Favor, unmute yourself, please. Unmute yourself and don't waste my time, please. Oh, okay. She's there. Okay. What have you learned tonight, Favor? I can't hear you. I think probably our network. I sometimes can be the speaker. Okay, because of our time, I don't. Are you there? Oh, okay. Bolu, do you want to tell me something? Let Olami talk. So Olami is going to talk tonight. And I'm super proud of Ola today. Ola, Shemilore's brother. So well done. You show your face throughout. Fantastic. Thank you. So allow me just to tell me what you plan tonight. Unmute yourself. Ola or Bolu, I want someone to talk among you then. Unmute yourself, darling. So Favor, send me three. Where's Favor? Okay. Oh, Favor, make sure you send me 3 minutes video talking about what you plan tonight. Thank you. So allow me, if you don't want to send me 10 minutes video, make sure you talk. So allow me, what have you learned?
We learned about the fruit of Jesus.
The fruit of the Spirit. Yeah, how we should, our actions, how we should behave, you know, as Christian. All those things, we need to have them. How many are there? I think someone said 7 and I can overhear Shalom telling us that it's 8 or 9 or something. Okay. So, children, we need to learn this. Let's watch this video again, okay? Thank you, Ola, for actually talking. So, don't forget your assignment, everyone. Tonight, you're going to write out the fruit of the Spirit, the one that you've been exhibiting, the one that you've been kind, the one that you've been using. You know, you're going to talk about it, send it to me, and then and the one you want to work on. Probably you've not been so kind, you know, something like that. So, you send it to us. Tell us the fruit of the Spirit, what the one you've exhibited, and the one you are praying to God, you know, to help you, so that you can have. And, yeah, I think that will be the end of our program tonight. Clap for yourself. Let's clap for ourselves. Clap for yourself. Well done. Thanks for connecting. And we look forward to seeing you next week. But let's pray before we go. Let's thank God for His grace. Let's thank God for the opportunity. Let's thank God for His Spirit. Let's thank God for His Word. Because the Word of God has come to us today. Because God wants us to be good. God don't want us to be ease. God does not want us to, you know, to backslide. Does not want the enemy to take us away. You know, that's why God is teaching us. He wants us to have all this quality so that we'll be, you know, so that we'll be closer to Him. So that we'll be relevant in His kingdom. Close your eyes to them. Make sure you are praying. Lord, I thank you for the word I've heard tonight. Let's pray. Let's pray for the spirit of the fruit of the Spirit. Let's pray that it will reflect in our lives. Before we find ourselves, yeah, I know some of us will be struggling with one or the other. You know, we don't have everything yet. Let's pray that God will help us, give us the grace to exhibit the fruit of the Spirit, so that wherever we go, people will see us and they will say, indeed, these are children of God. So let's pray. Close your eyes and pray. Lord, help me. Give me the grace to exhibit the fruit of the Spirit. Lord, give me the spirit. If it's the spirit of kindness you want, pray. If it's joy, you know, you want to be, some of you, you've not been happy, you've been, you know, pray that God give me. Close your eyes, make sure you are praying. Make sure you are praying, children. In Jesus name we pray, amen. So let me check the time. We have 2 minutes. Let's pray for our parents. Let's pray that God will uphold our parents. God will protect them. God will keep them. Close your eyes, make sure you are praying. God will bless them with everything they need to take care of us. Make sure you are praying. Make sure you are praying. Can you hear me, everyone? So make sure you are praying. I can't hear you. You've muted yourself, but that's fine. But ensure you are praying over there. Lord Jesus, we pray for our parents. We pray you continue to bless them with everything they need to take care of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're going to pray for ourselves now. Children, close your eyes. Make sure you are praying. Lord, help me to know you more. Lord Jesus, help me to know you more and help me to fulfill my destiny. Close your eyes and pray. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, I pray tonight, Lord, help me to know you more. Help me to know you more, oh Lord. I want to fulfill my destiny in you. I don't want the enemy to take me away. I don't want to miss it. Lord Jesus, give me the grace to know you more. Grace to connect every time, to hear from you, to listen to your word. Lord, give unto me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We have 1 minute, but let's pray this prayer again. Lord Jesus, help me Lord, help me, Lord, to remain in you. Lord, I want to remain in you. One of us need to pray that prayer very well. Last 2 weeks, I had a revelation about one of us. So you need to pray that prayer very well, okay? You know, because I pray, I teach you. Sometimes God will show some things to me about you. So I want us to pray now. I want one of us need to pray. Lord, help me. Lord, I will not backslide. I will not backslide. Lord Jesus, help me. Help me, oh Lord, to remain in you till the end. Help me, oh Lord. Close your eyes, make sure you are praying. Lord, I don't want to go back to the world. I don't want to become rascal. I don't want to become nonentity. I don't want to become vagabond. Lord Jesus, help me tonight. Help me, oh Lord. I want to be your child indeed. I pray for your grace to remain in you. Close your eyes, make sure you are praying. Lord, give me the grace to remain in you. Give me your grace. I will not bring disgrace to my family. I will not bring shame to my family. Lord Jesus, I will not bring disgrace to your name. Lord, help me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Wow. So the last prayer point now. Oh, two prayer points, children. So let's really pray for our sponsors. People who have been sponsoring us. Let's pray that God will bless them. God will expand them. Some of us are praying among them. Close your eyes. Pray for them. Pray that God will increase everyone that has been blessing us. Make sure you are praying. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father Lord, we pray for our sponsor. Father Lord, we pray, oh Lord, that you put them, you bless them, oh Lord. We pray, oh Lord, that you bless their family with everything they need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So we're going to pray for ourselves now. You know, most of us, half of us didn't connect tonight. I don't know why. So let's pray for ourselves. Let's pray that God will help us. That God will help give. Let's pray for Glory Christian Children, that God will expand us, God will increase us, and as every one of us, God will help us to know Him more, to love Him more. Close your eyes, make sure you are praying. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. And remember your teachers, the teacher that has taught us tonight, Brother Sheyi, that God will empower him, God will help him to know Him more. At the end of everything on earth, he will not miss heaven. Close your eyes and pray for your teachers. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, we pray, oh Lord. Lord, those who stay children, Lord, increase us, expand us. We pray for our teacher that you've used for us tonight. Father, we pray you replenish him. We pray you bless him, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, 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 in Jesus' name. Let's share the grace, children. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let's clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. So good to see you all tonight. God bless you. Have a lovely week ahead. Take care. Yeah, bye.
Thank you, Mom.
Bye. Bye-bye, darlings.
Bye.
Bless you. Where's Precious? Oh my God, this is Precious tonight. Anyway, I send my greetings to her. Oh, that's Precious over there. God bless you, my darling. Bye. Have a lovely night's rest. Bye-bye. Oh.